The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit
for
a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Of the Tiger Technician's Hour at noon to 1 every day, Eastern Time, that is, and the author of The Opening Call, a daily newsletter, very labor-intensive and detailed report every day on what we're looking at, the stocks we have, the ETFs or whatever it is, and the stops that we would have, the buy stops, where we want to enter, just very detailed. So let's get to the market. I'm focusing here first on the dollar, which is up 45 cents at 97.46. Doesn't sound like a big deal, but where it's taken off from has been very important. Why? Because if you're looking at this monthly chart of the dollar, it had a high of 103.82 back in January, and a low of 88.25 in February of 2018. And look at the technicals. I'm looking at the moving average convergence divergence, the MACD right here, this top technical tool, and on balance volume below it. And I love to see on balance volume above 80% and holding. Every textbook will say 80% or higher is called overbought, and under 20% is called oversold. And I say, no, you've got it completely wrong. The implication is that it's overbought and it should be going down. No, no, no. The implication should be that as long as it holds above 80%, the look back period is showing a very positive stance. And that as long as the price is moving together with this green line, the 9-period differential, the faster moving average, and the slow one is above 80%, that is really good. This is the in the slow stochastic there. And the MACD, as long as the green line, the 9-period, this is called the 9-period differential, is above the slow 26-period moving average, and there's a nice wide space, that gives you cushion. That says that if there is a pullback, that until that line, the green line crosses negatively, and this is a monthly chart, that's a positive action. So that says the dollar at 97.46 probably would have to start trading for a month or more under 94.20 before that MACD really turns down negative and the stochastic goes to about 68%. Okay, so in the meantime, back at the ranch, what we're looking at is that the dollar had a very nice move. It hasn't broken out. It breaks out if it starts to trade above 97.72, especially in the next 2 weeks if it can get to the 98 level. That'll be extremely positive action. All right, enough with the dollar. I'm just saying that the dollar has a couple of components that are very important. So one is that it is, for me, I always treat it as the currency that is the leading currency is invariably looking at an economy that is one of the leading economies of the world. Remember back in the 1980s, the yen was very strong, yet we were still starting to buy the Toyota and all the Japanese products. We couldn't get enough of them. And we were paying top dollar. You kept paying top dollar. Why? Because General Motors was using plastic parts in the engine. They did every single thing a little wrong. When I see these General Motors CEOs interviewed and they've written books and all that, I say that's just the most terrible thing. They dragged the Chrysler and General Motors and Ford, they dragged them down. All right, enough. What we're looking at here is I think that the dollar is representing what we're looking at in the country, and that is that the economy, the unemployment rate, there are a lot of aspects that are extremely good, and world currencies, world countries are treating this as a very big positive, and they are buying the dollar. That's, I'm making it simple. That's the way I look at it. Let's get on with the nitty-gritties. And gold, I know a lot of people looking at gold, but gold, I think it's been in its own trajectory. It's been more a currency of fear. And all I can say is that if it breaks this weekly, this, so it's a daily chart on the left. See these big arch formations. Let me just show you. In the Chapman wave, you're always looking for different things. Actually, let me do it from here. I've got, this is from a webinar I just recently did. So this is what we look for in the Chapman wave methodology. You find the lowest, most obvious low bar, and you merely count each successively higher peak. You alphabetize them, uppercase A, the next peak is B, next higher peak is C, next higher peak is D. At D, the fourth highest peak, other things can happen. It can go to E, F, and G. Then it has to recycle. So that's the one thing that we're looking for. Then I always say that there are just three patterns in the market, straight up, straight down, that's one. Arch or cup, that's two. And you can treat that almost as if the arch is one, because there are always patterns that come about based on the arch formation, where you go from one level, rally, and then come back and retest it. Or you come back from one point, you come back down, and then you go up to retest the high. So that leads you to this, where you can get a pattern that I call the lowercase h, the dreaded h red, because when it takes out that left side low, it can go make a whole bunch of these things on the way down. And the inverted y, or the upside down h, where on the left side, you've climbed up, you make a cup shape, you try to test the left side high. If you break that, that's really important. There are other implications. Let's see how that works in real life. Look at this. The arch formation takes out the left side low that was made in gold back in March, but it still manages to rally a little bit, and then it fails, makes a second little mini arch. Let me just draw it in for you. Second one, smaller one, like an inverted cup and handle. What does it do? It breaks down. Now it's gone to a leg C to the E slash C to the downside. MACD's weak stochastic is at a point where at 9%, it should attempt to rally. But the big thing here is, look, there's your H pattern. You go to peak E, you turn down, you make an arch, and we've taken out that low. That makes this trend line in the weekly chart really important to hold over the next week. And let's call it 1268. A close below 1270, 1260. Let's call it 1268. Would be a very big negative. And here's the arch formation in the weekly. That means that gold has got a lot more work to do to get out of this downtrend. Now, let's go to the indices themselves, the Dow itself. Look at that pattern. You remember what we were talking about a moment ago? There's the cup formation. Here's the second one. Here's that cup formation that tested the left side high, 26,241 in February. February the 25th, pulls back to 25,252, makes another cup formation, makes a cup formation, and then with a little doji candle at 26,487, on the 5th of April, pulls back a little bit, and now it's gone to another recovery high. All-time high is 26,951. Think of the V-shaped pattern as a sharp cup. In other words, comes straight down, goes straight up. Look at the way the QQQ, this is the NDX 100, took out that left side high of 187.53 back in October. Now it's trying to test it. Will it break out, or will it pull back a little bit, have a little bit of a rest before it goes higher? I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, subbing for Tom O'Brien away, and I'll be back straight off these messages. The Dow was up 130, and the S&P is up 6.76.
Hi folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly gold report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly gold report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-76.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman, the host of the Tiger Technicians Hour, sitting in for Tom O'Brien and the Tom O'Brien Show. It's my pleasure to be here. The Dow is up 135, S&P is up 7. And this is usually a time when Tom would be interviewing me. So let me just go through a couple of things just so you know what I do here. I've been here over, 15 years, I think, here at TFNN. My noontime show, it's 12 o'clock till 1 o'clock Eastern time, call-in show, just like this is. And I do an analysis of the stocks. And my service is called The Opening Call. It's a very detailed report. I tell exactly what I show what I'm looking at with a different charts every single day. Now, my Traders Corner, we have a number of issues I have. For instance, maybe I can even show it today. I don't think there's a problem with that. I'll show you what I did for today. Today's Thursday. Here it is. So this is my newsletter. This is the final page. It's called The Trader's Corner. Happy Easter and happy Passover to those celebrating. No, today I'll be doing 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. Tom O'Brien Show. And you can call, etc. And then these are the positions that we have. There are 16 bullet points. We don't have 16 positions. We actually have the most that I try not to get more than 8. Sometimes we'll go to 9. But invariably, when I go to 8 or 9, we're real close to some kind of a top. That's just the way it is. So let me explain a couple of things that I've been doing here. Let's grab this, move it away. So if I can go through, and I'll go through some of the stocks. For instance, we're long Bank of America. We've been long Bank of America at in the 24s since December, 24.45. It's trading at 30.06. We've had that same position in the 24s once before. Did very nice. We took it out, and then we waited for the big pullback, got back in. So that's doing very well. It's up 6 points right now. So that's still looking very strong. Another position that we have I want to go through positions that make the most sense because a lot of people are very selective. So I'm going to be looking at some of the bigger positions because I mean bigger in the sense that these are what majority of people would have on their list rather than the smaller stocks. So the IAI is the broker-dealer iShares, broker-dealer and security ETF. And we're long from 60. And it's trading at 63.12. And this is a move that was really important because we want to be able to check out how the general public is coming to the market. My sense of the market is that until this really starts to, I'd say originally, if it can get into the 63s, I think you'll start to see the public really climbing in. I got a feeling it'll have to be the 65s, and you need to see the Dow very nicely in the 27,000s. That might be, hey, to the next week maybe, but I'm hoping for some kind of a decent pullback here for new positions to be put on. Meantime, it's at 63.14. You've got leg D in the Chapman Wave daily chart. The MACD is very strong. Stochastic's at 93%. That's good. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a little bit of a pullback next week, but I like this sector itself. It doesn't have to be the IA, but this is the generic index. We want to go for specific stocks, which we're starting to do. In my webinar, I had I discussed all these things that we're looking at for this coming year, 2019 to 2020. Then leg C is bumping into this resistance right here in the weekly chart from November, the high of 63.72. The high today is 63.43. We're almost there. And the MACD is good. Stochastic's okay at 75%. It's not great. That's the reason why I think there could be some kind of a pullback. Maybe time more than price. We've got the Chapman Wave leg, body. The neck is just starting now. We could still come back in here and mess around in the 61-ish area. We'll see. But the monthly chart is now starting to improve a lot. We've got the IYT. So, yes, we have some ETFs because I want you to be more generic. Just in this phase of the market, we have been more specific at times, and we'll get more specific as we move into the summer months. So we're looking at leg D at 197.85 in the IYT, which is the iShares Transportation Average. What's really important about this, we're along from 186 area. So it's 11 points. Yeah, that's very nice. But what's really important is we wanted to take it to D and see what happens. We're in leg D. And in the weekly chart, we still want to take it to at least a D. In fact, I'd like to hold this much longer. It's great in terms of Dow theory, that you're getting the Dow running strongly and you're getting the transports running strongly. You want to see that. Theory really talks about when they're making new highs. Doesn't matter. I think it's very important for the economy, as a measure of the economy, that you see the transports, even with the airlines being hammered. This is really good action. And what we are looking at here is the weekly chart technicals have really improved. Look, the stochastic's at 92%, well over 80% in the weekly. The daily's only at 89%. It's kind of lagging, but I think this is very good action with the MACD. The weekly, the monthly chart has a lot to do, but the price is fabulous, but the technicals haven't really caught up yet. So we're waiting for the MACD to cross positive. That might have to be another 10 points and then maybe another month or two before that can happen. We'll see. Now, another thing we're looking at here, we're along the dollar. And I mentioned the dollar before. We've had a one-year anniversary on the 6th of April of 2018. We bought it, so we're into our second year. But it's just the beginning. We've had a year, and it's holding very well. We're along via the UUP, which is a trading vehicle for this, and was equivalent to dollar at 90.07, and the dollar has hit 97.71 twice. I'm hoping that it's going to break above that to really display price strength rather than just the internal strength that's been appearing for quite some time in the monthly chart. If you look at the euro, look at this. The euro is just, this is just a terrible chart. And look at this weekly chart. Look at those red candles. Look at the monthly chart. The euro better not break the low that was made, one point right here. That was in April 1st, I think it was, April the 2nd, 1.118. If it takes that out, that is just not going to be good news at all. So that's looking at that. Now the TLT, I just want to mention this before we do anything else, has made a trough D after making a peak. Do you remember how important the Ds are? 126.69 on the 28th of March, the TLT, the Lehman 20-year T-bond fund, comes down to a trough D. Yesterday made a low, today it's bounced up. My thinking here is that if the TLT starts to rally towards the 125s and it coincides with the general market starting to pull back, that'll say, okay, timeout is unfolding. Why? Because money will be coming out of the volatility of The equities, remember, people talk about volatility only when it's going down. They don't talk about volatility on the way up. All those ads you hear where people say, volatility, volatility. Hey, this is one of the least volatile periods we've had in years. Anyway, meantime, back at the ranch, if the money flows out of equities and goes into bonds, you'll see a digestive phase unfolding in the general market. And just quickly, I'll tell you, crude oil, it's kind of stuck in a range. I call this a rectangle formation. It can stay in a rectangle for quite a while, and then eventually it pops a little bit out, and then it takes out the low. And the result is that it starts to dip down. I think 62 to 61.5 is very strong support for crude oil. Meantime, it's just stuck in the upper part of the range against the weekly 200 period moving average, this orange line right here. Technicals are very good. I don't think it's going to pull back too much. If it does, I think it's going to be getting higher in the summer months. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman for Tom O'Brien. This is the Tom O'Brien Hour, and the Dow's up 144.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial, so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Tom O'Brien, the vacationing Tom O'Brien, actually, I think, business trip. Well, we're looking at the XLI. I sent an email saying, look at the XLI. Well, the XLI is the S&P Industrial Spider Fund. Now, keep your eye. Look at the left side chart. Let me squeeze that a little bit so you can see the, oops, this is the middle one. I want the left side one. I want to squeeze. Now, look at this. So you've got this cup formation. It double tops. It pulls back, makes a handle. Not one of my favorite patterns, the cup and handle. because they usually come back and do a retest of the handle load. But this one did it perfectly by pulling back and then spiraling up. And this is a different wave count to the Dow. So the Dow is the industrials, right? But the XL, the S&P has an industrial conglomerate much bigger. We've got the Dow 30. But what I am looking at here is that there's a difference because the makeup of the Dow is somewhat different to the S&P industrials. I haven't looked at it for a while, but when I last looked, I noticed that there were more industrial type. When you think of the Dow 30, how can you call Disney an industrial? Does that make sense? Chevron, maybe the old traditional Chevron and ExxonMobil, but Intel? Dow DuPont maybe fits in the category, but Disney? You know, it's a real mix now. I actually like the mix very much. But when you look at the chart, you'll see the Dow has broken out. Let me just do this. I want you to keep your eye on the left side chart. We will talk about the middle one and the right one, the weekly in the middle, the monthly on the right. Just keep your eye. Here we go. Left side chart from the XLR is now going to change to what? It's going to change to the IDU. This is the Dow Industrials. You see this chart? Yeah, it's got all my notations, etc. It's a little cluttered, but that spiral to the upside is suggesting that this leg here is only in a leg B. It isn't in a leg like I've got G/C. And that weekly chart, you see where we are in the V-shaped pattern? And you see where we are in the monthly. Keep your eye. Let's look at this again. Here we go. XLI, XLI. And you'll see that there's a difference. This has gone much higher on the left side to the right side. Look, there's the right side high of 77s. Now it's at 78.35. But that is a much higher a candle. And it didn't have a little peak. It didn't have a peak here to make this at least a C. There was a 2 cents higher. So, yeah. 2 cents high means you keep the wave count going. This is, once you break above that A at 77.25, that becomes a floating letter. So this B becomes right here. It becomes G/B, B, and now G/B with the characteristic is more of a B with a stochastic at 92% than MACD. Good. And that's suggesting, wow, we could even have a good week next week. I was thinking consolidation. Now I have to maybe rethink this. You could still pull back, but I'm saying this is very good action. And look at the weekly chart. The weekly chart, the stochastic's 93%. I don't remember if it was as high as that in the 95%. Okay, 95% in the, so the pattern's a little bit different, but the Dow is stronger technically. So I'm looking at this and I'm saying, well, a good day like this, up 0.54%. This is showing buying pressure, right? And this is with, you know, we haven't had any real bad news. There was a potential for bad news this morning. If the Mueller report, you have to wonder why there was such a big fuss that Mueller had 4 days. He didn't have 4 days. He had, if you remember, he had 3 weeks. And then he had 4 days in which to write the report, but he was actually looking at it for a period. And then you have to wonder why everyone's saying this morning that within seconds they were already breaking it down and having most of the media that I heard anyway, and the Boston Globe just sent an email email out talking about it. How did they make these decisions in minutes? How come there's 400 pages and they were able within minutes to do the same thing? Something's wrong with this picture. That's all I can say. With the market, thank goodness, is saying, you know what? We've got bigger fish to fry. The dollar is telling us that our economy is respected around the world, and that's important. And the country says, we are buying stocks. That's what's happening with the market as strong as it is. And I like that. That's really important. You want a strong economy. It's a really, every country needs a strong economy so that they can, you know, help create jobs. You can help the poor. It's just really important. Colleges, tuition. How do you think all the scholarships are made? They're made with money that is made, you know, in the economy and in the stock market. So that's very important. Anyway, so all right. So that was the area that we were looking at. So I said IYT, we've been long and it's done very well. And then we could have some silly things that small stocks that were off other people's radar, but which seemed to me at this particular time to be good. For instance, the whole shipping area seemed to me to be kind of something's going on. There has to be good shipping, and therefore we've got a shipping type stock. It's called YRC Worldwide Inc. This is a low price stock. I like to mix things up so that my subscribers are in all categories are able to buy. So this we bought at $7.58. It's trading right now at $8.06. Really nice day. It had a high of 8.15. So we bought it today. Is the what is today? Today's the 18th. Bought it 3 days ago. So it's had a what is that? We bought it at 58 cents, and it's now at 0.06. Yeah. So that's 63. It's about a 9% gain in a couple of days. Very nice. So this is what we try to do. It's really important. I put a lot of work into my newsletter, and hopefully I can, you know, satisfy as many people as possible. And this is a leg D in the weekly chart. That's a little bit of a worry, but as long as it's holding well, I like that. The technicals are improving a lot. Monthly chart needs a lot of work. YRC Worldwide Inc. Custom deliveries, that's all. And I'm looking for a retest in the cup to the cup and handle pattern of the 858 area. Then we'll have to make some decisions if it gets there. So this is the kind of thing that I do. Most importantly, we have areas of in the, this is, for instance, this is wheat, which is pulled back. It's at 44, 45 and a half. It's down 1.5. Soy is, it was also a little bit, oh, it's a little stronger today, up 1.75 at 880. You've got corn, as I say here in the Boston area. Corn holding quite nicely at the bottom with an H to M pattern, needs very quickly to get to the 361s, so it's at 358 and a half. So we have an ETF that basically covers the agricultural sector. And this, we've never done that before. We've had the DBC, which is has more of a crude oil weighting. DBC has done very well. This was the one we have has been somewhat of a laggard, but my suspicion was that it would play catch up in the big picture for 2019 going to 2020. I don't know if it's going to work, but we got in very nicely, and so far it's holding. So these are the things that I do for subscribers. Just thought I'd mention that. Okay, so that's my usual interview. Every other week I do an interview with Tom, Thursday at 4:20, and we're only having an hour today. And Tuesday at 3:20, every other Tuesday. So I'll be back, and the Dow's up 124, S&P's up 5, and we'll have a real quick look at the futures. Went to a peak D right there. Yep, peak D, and now it's pulling back in the 5-minute chart.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a 4-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal 4-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the 4-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted.
Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Hi, folks, we're back. So a couple of questions came in. Let me just get to them. One right now, one's in the den. KL, TB wants to know what's happening here. This is Kirkland Lake Gold. When I looked at, I don't know how many decades I've been getting Investors Business Daily. I even remember meeting Bill O'Neill way back in the 1980s. And it's really a fabulous paper. But I have to tell you, I don't look at it. I get it online every day, but I never really look at it. There's just no time. There's so many things to do. But on the weekends, I do look at it or I buy the paper. I prefer to actually handhold the paper. So Kirkland Gold shocked me one day when I looked at the top 50. Kirkland Lake Gold was there. KL is the symbol. And it's had a spectacular run from its IPO way back in 2017. What was that? That was in February of 2017, 6.71. 3 months ago, it hits. It's a five-bagger. Right, it goes to 36.74. Really nice. So now it's pulling back, digesting the gains. I've got an alternate account for the weekly, but it's holding above the 14-period moving average. It's between the 9 and the 14, the green and the black. The MACD's turned negative, stochastic's negative, but the price is holding. So this is what I'm looking at here. Let me show you the bigger picture. In Kirkland, what we've got is there's an arch formation, and now we're starting the handle part of it. So if you are long, you're a very long-term holder, all I'm going to say to you is I don't want to mess with your position because you obviously thought it through and you've held it and you've done very well. If you're just recently into the stock, and I'm about to sneeze, excuse me, usually save those for my noontime show, then what I'd be looking at here is I'd say, I like to look at it this way. Would I buy it here or would I hold? Would I sell it? It's real simple. If you're in it and you're long and you have a reasoning for that, that's one thing. But right now, what would I do? At 31.37, down 32 cents. I'd say, you know what, I'm going to wait a little longer. The MACD is flat, which holds the last arrow down or arrow up. In this case, it's an arrow down, so it's a down mode. Stochastic's at a 53%. It's okay, but it's not great. I would just say I would not do anything right now. I want to see how it holds support round about this candle low of the 4th of April at the 31.85 level. So I meant 30.76, and it's at 31.34 right now. If it takes that out, I'm going to say to you, gee, you know, that cup and handle, it looks to me like it wants to at least get into the body of this candle of the 2nd of April, high of 31.10, low of 29.15, and then I'd have to reassess it. At this point, I'd actually do nothing. Now, let's just imagine that you're long. I don't know whether you're long or not, but if you are long, and you'd be long for quite a while, and you'd like to buy and hold, but you're also a little afraid of the shorter term, then you know what I'd recommend. If you're long and you don't want to give up any more of the profits that you've got, why don't you take just a little bit off and plan to put that back? And I'd put it back somewhere. I don't want to see the low of April of 2 weeks ago, the low of 29.15 taken out. So what I would say is that the pattern I'm looking at suggests there's a little bit more digestion to be had. So hold off. I'm just saying to you, take it right now, if you want. I don't want to mess your position up because, you know, gold is a weird instrument. Next thing, next week, we could just suddenly see dollar pulling back or dollar holding, doing nothing, but gold suddenly has a big spike to the upside. I'm just going to say to you, if you are a little nervous and say to yourself, you know, I've had a really good gain, I don't want to give up the gain, but I also don't want to lose the position, just take a little bit off your position. Or if there's an option, just buy a call option for later on, and just say you can do anything you want right now. I've got a call option and we can be back at whatever it is. So you buy maybe in the money 30 call, or you could do the exact opposite. You know, I don't want to mess my position up. I'm going to buy a 31.5 if there is, or a 32.5 put position. There's your guarantee. But if you don't want to do that, I just say to you, be careful. You can take a little bit off, plan to put it on, and don't put it on until you see how it tests this whole 31 to 30 key support area. I hope that helps you. But looking at the monthly chart is still very good. And the weekly chart is saying is good, but it's overbought. So it should be pulling back. And that's really what I'm looking at. That even if it rallies, I suspect it's in a trading band between the 33-ish area and the 29s for a little bit longer. Hope that helps you, TV. Okay, next question is Hector says, hi, Basil. I get the feeling that NBEV will either be up double overnight or get cut in half. Can this stock be setting up for a rogue wave situation? That's where you just suddenly see a big spike to the upside when the technicals are still negative. I bought more at 5:30 and intend to hold through summer. Hector, you know, I'm going to go right there. I looked at it last night, and my conclusion was, let's see if I was correct in that. NBEV is trading at $5.25. It's up one, it's down a penny. There's this pattern that I discussed the other day. It's called the Eiffel Tower. It goes straight up and straight down like an uppercase A. And that's what we've got. You can see it very nicely in the daily chart. I'll expand that. Now, the one of the positions we have is in the MJ, which is the alternative harvest, because I think this is going to be a sector for various phases of this year. But I think it's still so early in the game. We've got to have some leverage. We've got to have some stops where they're a little bit wider. So this is what I'm thinking. I believe that New Age Beverage Corporation is in play. I'm a little concerned about this huge move that went to 10 in 1 month. It goes from $1.47 to 10. This is a huge consolidation of that big move. And I gave a notation. I'm going to take this away because I explained why we did this. So let me just get rid of this. Here we go. Okay. So now it's a cleaner chart. So the weekly chart is saying to me, we've had an H attempt. We're having another H attempt, which should turn out to be like a W formation, two U's next to one another. And I think that you're right. I think this is a stock that you want to buy. You bought it at 5:30, and it's trading at 5:25. If you say you're prepared to hold it, it means that regardless of what I say, it doesn't matter. So here's my thinking about this. That big news-related spike of the other day, the last one, not the big one that I was talking about back in August or so, September of last year. I'm talking about the most recent one that was on the 6th, was it 8th of April, 6th of April, right here. Yes, April the 8th. It has a low of 5:25 and a high of 669. I mean, that is really, yeah. Wait, and the day before, it was on the 200 period moving average, just hanging out in an arch formation at the lows at 472. So I think this is just a news related event. I don't like that. What that does is it takes away a lot of both the two things. It takes away the integrity of the stock because now people can't trust it because they, oh man, does it make a spike and give it all back? I just have to wait. Or you have to say to yourself, the characteristic of the stock is one of news-related events. I'm looking at it like a biotech. You remember the biotechs in the old days? They'd still do it, but in the old days, we saw it all the time, where the biotechs, it almost looked as if every 3 months they were paying their CEOs because there was no money coming in with stocks. So the stocks would spiral up because somebody kept pushing it up. so that these guys could sell it, and that's how they got their salary. I'm just thinking out loud. I don't know. So I'm looking at this, and I'm saying to you, Hector, I think you've got your eye on a particular prize, but you've got to be prepared for some whipsaw. 484 is the stop I would have, but in the meantime, that's really a very important. The 480s must hold on any pullback. I'll be back. Basil Chapman sitting in for Tom O'Brien, and the Dow's up 123.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
We're back. Last segment before the Easter weekend and Passover weekend. For those celebrating, I wish you well. I wish everyone a wonderful long weekend. We're closed tomorrow. And I look at this, peak D. Remember we spoke about the importance of a peak D in the Chapman Wave methodology? There it is. Here's your peak D. 29, the futures. This is the five-minute chart. 29.11.25. We're now down to 29.07. So these are the things that I show every day in my newsletter. I wonder if I can find this here. Let me just see. This is talking about, this is the 120-minute. I spoke about the gap. There was a chance that we could go higher. And what would happen at 130 would be very important. But we're looking at Chapman Wave 5 and a Chapman Wave G/C in the 120-minute chart right there. There's still this huge gap. I believe it will be filled in over the coming 5 to 8 days. And look, the MACD was starting to turn down a little bit, and the stochastic was still was negative in the 120-minute chart. Let's see the real thing. We'll go here. This is a 120-minute chart is right there. And there it is. And my automated resistance points are right here, 26,591, 26,606, 26,646, and 26,692. These are generated through the method that I developed over the years. It's automated generation of resistance and support levels. So it's going to be tough to break out, I think, over the next few days. I think we're in for some kind of a digestive phase. We made our peak C, and now we're in leg D. So the 120-minute chart is completed exactly what I wanted. Let's see what happens next week. And with that said, let me just do a couple of things to wrap it up. We're looking at the VIX, IYR, that's the U.S. iShares Dow Jones REITs Index, had a spectacular move from December lows from the 71 area to the recent high of 80, just under 88. And now it's right at 88, so now it's pulling back a little bit. So be careful. Watch the VIX. The VIX is back down in the 12s, down in the 12s, below the teens. That's high pressure. So if the VIX at any point next week starts to get 15s, we will be in for a well-deserved breather. Have a wonderful weekend, everyone. Check out my opening call and my newsletter. It's right on the front page of TFN, plus my webinars. Have a great weekend.